our planet. Let us all together save our planet. Thank you, sir.
Very good. Thank you so much. Next speaker is CPV Mithun Reddy.
Thank you, sir, for letting me talk on this very important issue of air pollution and climate change. It's a burning issue right now. To understand the gravity of this situation and the magnanimity of this issue, the speakers earlier also have spoken. We have the dubious distinction of having 13 of the most 20 polluted cities in the world. Earlier also, our honorable member from TMC was saying we have 9 out of 10. So if this is the situation, I think it is time to act. We don't have enough time also for this, and every day counts for this, sir. The whole pollution, we can attribute it to the fact that continuous urbanization, industrialization, and increase in the number of automobiles in a very short period of time. And we have various pollutants like nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, lead, and suspended particulate matter. More than 95% of the emissions from combustible gases or automobiles have a PM 2.5. PM is like a particulate matter which with an aerodynamic diameter less than 2.5 micrograms. And this is very small, sir, like the speakers earlier told. It can be easily, it goes into the through our respiratory system into our organs. It can choke the organs, and this is very dangerous. The World Health Organization, in their report, have stated that for PM 2.5, it is 25 micrograms per square or per cubic meter. So if it is only 25, I would like to share a report which was there on papers on November 3rd, especially in Delhi. The PM 2.5 for a 24-hour period was 625 micrograms. And this is 24 times more than the World Health Organization permitted levels, which is very, very high. So if this is the case, we can understand what is the state of the people living in our capital. Not only our capitals, but throughout the nation, we need to take steps to curb this menace of air pollution. It is particularly complicated in Delhi because of the huge number of automobile population. They have automobiles more than Bombay, Chennai and Calcutta put together, and also due to this stubble burning problem. In India, studies have revealed that the third highest cause of death due to health risks is air pollution, and studies by Health Effects Institute said that almost 1.2 million deaths in India in 2017 were due to because of this air pollution. So we need to act in a way where the common public do not get affected for no fault of theirs. Air pollution is a group 1 carcinogen and highly toxic, and the contents are similar to that of smoke generated from cigarette. If this is the case, smoking happens like now and then people smoke, but in polluted cities, like you smoke it as good as smoking for 24 hours, and this is going to play a huge role on the economy. This stage where we are fighting a recession, and this particular time where we are targeting a 5 trillion economy, we don't need to spend, we don't need to drain our coffers for mitigating the problems we have created. We don't need to drain our people's money for no fault of this. So we need to act on this, and it is a very, very important issue right now. And there is a and coming to climate change. Climate change is a important issue. We have seen a spate of incidents which have happened in our country, and especially our India is very vulnerable to climate change because we have a huge coast. Even small levels of rise in the sea will affect us drastically. We have seen earlier what happened in Kerala, we have seen earlier what happened in Chennai and Bombay. Huge areas were inundated, and in Chennai where especially in Chennai, people use boats to commute in the main roads. So all this is because of adverse climate conditions, adverse climate impact, and we also have a huge Himalayan range, which is a gateway to India. Even slight changes in temperature will spoil the whole ecosystem, and it will have an adverse impact on the whole balance of the Ganges plains. So the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, has predicted that global warming will increase the temperature drastically in India, which will be above the global average. So this increase in temperature will play a very devastating role on our country, and this would increase frequency and intensity of extreme climatic events. And according to the report of our Parliamentary Standing Committee on Agriculture, they have predicted that 4 to 9% of our agriculture economy will be affected by this climate change. And if this is the case, almost 1.5% of our GDP will be affected. So these things can be avoided, as we have 60% of our population thriving on agriculture, and it's very important for us to move forward as a country. The threat to life and loss of work will lead to huge migrations, and we need to be in a situation to embrace all this, or we need to be in a situation to handle this huge migrations. Already we are having huge urbanization going on, and we have to, there are two, three things like which the government has taken it up positively, but I think it should be carried out to the bottom level. It's like we have nationally determined goals as agreed in the Paris Agreement. India launched the solar alliance to reach the target of 40% dependence on renewable energy. It is a very good initiative, and even the Bharat 4 norms for automobile industry, this is also very good, because it will reduce the PM2.5% in the air to almost down by 80%, and the subsidy for electric vehicles, which is to the tune of 1.5 lakhs per vehicle, this is also a good initiative. Sir, I would like to sum it up saying that we need a collective effort. It's not just like I heard people saying this is a state subject, and some people saying that it's a central subject, and saying each one of us blaming each and other parties. But I will guarantee one thing, sir, let people from the state or let people from the center, any party, breathe this air, everybody is going to end up in the hospital. We need to put petty politics aside. We need to put everything aside and act on this together. There was a famous quote by an important person. He said, if you don't act in time, we are going to be put into a smoggy irrelevance. We are going to be pushed to smoggy irrelevance. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Honorable Member Sri Arvind Sound.
Jai Maharashtra. Adaniya Sabhapati Mahode.
Please.
आज एक महत्वपूर्ण विषय, खास करके गंभीर विषय पर चर्चा इस सदन में हो रही है. मुझे याद है कि पिछले सत्र में मैंने इस विषय पर कॉलिंग अटेंशन दी थी.